How do you know when and where to use the correct fiber? That's what we're going to talk about today. Let's get started. Super fast wardrobe change here. Welcome back. It's good to see all of you. The reason why I did a quick wardrobe change is this is a sweater that I knitted a long time ago, a few years ago it is. Now, it is done in a sport weight that I used to carry. I sold the last two skeins of that said sport weight last Saturday. And I'm not sure if you can tell, it is a merino nylon blend, and you can see that there's some wear on this sweater already, and it's starting to pill and get fuzzy on me. So when and where to use the correct fiber for what you're doing? That is the topic of today's video. So last Saturday, I had a customer that asked me what BFL was. And I'm like, BFL is a type or breed of sheep. Every sheep breed has its own characteristics, it has its own length, it has its own shape, its size, how curly or not curly it is, how long the staple length, how resilient that fiber is, how much bounce, how much elasticity it has. And that's why fiber mills blend fibers together to accentuate that quality and characteristic of each fiber to make something that's very useful. But it's useful for only certain things. And that's something to take into consideration because, again, I was blown away because some people don't know their fibers. So it's time to learn your fibers. And the reason why behind it and where to use it. So like I said, this one was done in sport weight. It is a merino nylon. Everyone loves my sport weight that I had in. And of course it's green, one of my favorite colors. This sweater was top down, easy, even though there's lace on it. Now this sweater, on the other hand, that I did took 8.5 months. 8.5 months, why? I just had other things and it was just, yeah. But as you can tell, this sweater has been worn as well and washed and still shows really great stitch definition. This is BFL and nylon. It is a DK weight that I used on this and huge difference. Huge difference in wear, huge difference in staple length, and I'm gonna show you some socks. I'm not proud of them, they're just basic socks. I make 2 pair for my husband a year because he wears holes in them. I'm sorry for the shake here. So 2 pairs. And this is one that's been very well worn and washed. And can you tell how odd shaped it is? It didn't hold up. So this was a merino nylon that was in my stash. It's not one of my yarns that I did make or create. And it's just doesn't look like a sock at all. It looks, yeah, like an adult foot would really fit into this. There's no holes in it. That's not the issue. It's just not holding its shape, and it also is peeling and getting fuzzy in along areas. Now, again, and this should be your new BFF. BFL is your new BFF, which also stands for, it's short for, Blue Face Leaster. That's the type of sheep. This sock, look, it looks like a sock. It has its heel. If I would put it into a foot, it still has its shape. And that's why you wash and block them. Still stitch definition, not very much fuzz on that sock at all. And not much wear in the heel. There's some. But my point being is the size really matters. Size meaning the micron count, the staple length, the characteristics of the wool. Yes, it does matter. Because say if you're doing something like a sweater, which is a big project that might take you a month to, like in my case, 8.5 months to complete, you don't want it ruined and unwearable, or it stretches here and it's tight here, or you know, it just loses its shape and it doesn't bounce back. That's why you need to learn a little bit more about the fibers that you're using and what they're best suited for. With that being said, I have some lace that are, and this is a, they are a long wool shape. So BFL will give you staple length. And why does staple length matter? Just imagine if you're not a hand spinner and you just knit and crochet, that when yarn is spun, the staple length matters, because as you're pulling to create each of those plies, the longer staple length, the less ends, which creates the peeling effect. So BFL has a longer staple length. Super soft, microns are there, next to skin, very great elasticity and bounce back. Add it with some nylon and boom, you've got a really good long wearing, hard wearing yarn. So that if I want to have it next to skin and make a beautiful sweater, I feel perfectly A-okay that it's gonna hold its shape after I wash and block it. I can get it to bounce back year after year as long as I care for it correctly. Now I have, because BFL is my BFF in here, I have, look at these curls. This is from Prairie. She has a little farm that she does for her retirement. And this is Lucy's Locks. And I have 2 pounds of Lucy's Locks here that have been sitting because I really haven't figured out how I want to spin it. But again, the lock is on the longer side, but this is BFL and Gotland. So these are two types of sheep that were bred together to create this. And I have one, and look at that staple length. Even though it is a BFL and Gotland, look at those curls though. A lot curlier than the straight BFL, but it is bred specifically to create unique characteristics. So this, I don't want to bore you with all the you know, scientific reasons behind why you really should consider what you're picking up, what you're purchasing, what you're looking after, project-wise. I have a lot of people that come into the show and they have in their tote bags or on their phones every pattern that they want to do. And that's awesome. You know what you want to create, but you need to learn how best to create it in what fiber so it lasts a lot longer and you don't get, like I said, these socks, big difference. Big difference, because this one has lost all of its shape and it has no elasticity. And there's so many different yarn bases out there. I introduced two new yarn bases last Saturday. And unfortunately, they're not up on the website just yet. The one has cashmere in it and nylon. It is a super fine merino. And it's 80, 10, and 10. And it's just, it feels like a cloud. Now, will it be good for socks? No. I have another yarn base that's 85, 15. 85 super fine merino, which I'm talking super fine, like 19 microns. Super soft. But it only has 15% nylon. Will it be good for socks? No. Why am I saying no? I would say 75% merino, 25% Nylon would be your best bet if you're going to do socks, and stick with the merino family. But I have 100% superwash BFL that I have, and it will wear like iron and keep its shape and withstand this. So moving forward, I'll get into some more depth of what best uses are for what fibers, because there's so many breeds out there that a lot of people have not heard of. But people who spin like I do or dye yarn, you know, we learn because we want to try new things. And a lot of people, when they're shopping for yarn, all they do is go for feel and look, meaning color. They don't figure how many plies it is, because you wouldn't want to knit a sweater with a one ply yarn and in merino, because merino staple length is only 1 inch to 3.5 inches. So you're going to have more ends in that one ply, and it's just going to fall apart. It's just not suited for it. So that's something I'm going to go into a little bit more and more as I think about it, because I think we all need a little bit more education, not just go by touch and feel. Touch and feel is good, but if you're going to sit there and put time, money, effort, and your creativity out there, you want it to last. So I hope this gets you thinking a little bit. Like I said, we'll go into some more depth. If that's something you like, please like this video so I know, so I can continue rambling on about different wools and their characteristics and yarns and what bases would work. Subscribe if you aren't already, and hit the bell so you can get notified when I post a new video. I'll see you in the next one.